Hey everybody, Prestige here. Today we have an interesting unboxing video for something called the BitBoy FC Mini. Now, prior to receiving an email from the company itself, I had never heard of this product, and after doing a little bit of research, I thought it would be something cool that you guys could check out as well. BitBoy also sent me an additional unit to give away to all of you that are watching this video right now. So simply to enter, like the video, leave a comment down below letting me know what your favorite retro game is, and follow me over on Twitter where I will be publicly announcing the winner. I will also put a pinned comment on this video when I announce the winner at the end of this week. Alright, so opening up the box, you can see that it comes with the BitBoy unit itself, which resembles a Game Boy. It also comes with an AV cable and, of course, a USB charging cable. What is the BitBoy, though? It's an emulator that fits in the palm of your hands, and it plays NES and SNES games. On the top of the device, you'll also notice that there is a slot for a micro SD card. Unfortunately, this is just for show. There's nothing actually behind that. There's no way to put an SD card in this and expand the amount of games you have. You cannot apply your own ROMs. What you see is what you get. 129 games in one, and of course, this is liable to change as well. Even on the box, it says there are 300 games in one, and unfortunately, that's just not the case. There were many duplicate ROMs on the BitBoy, so they decided to remove many of them, and of course, we ended up with 129 in one. Unlike the Game Boy or Game Boy Color, you're not gonna have to worry about fumbling around for AA batteries. This does come with a rechargeable 500 milliamp hour lithium battery. And funny enough, this is actually the same exact battery used within the Game Boy Advanced. It even says Game Boy Advanced right on the battery itself. Based on my usage on a full charge, you'll be able to get between 1 hour 45 minutes to 2 hour and 30 minutes gameplay time before you need to recharge it. Unfortunately, you cannot extend this gameplay time by dimming the screen. That's just not a feature on the BitBoy. However, the screen itself was surprisingly impressive. It's a 2.2 inch IPS display. It's very bright, it's very vibrant, and of course, you're going to see everything from multiple viewing angles. If you're in a car, if you're in a plane, if you're on the go, you'll be able to see it just fine. The BitBoy also comes with an AV cable, 2.5mm jack plugs directly into the device, and then the composite goes on the input of your TV. If you have an HD TV with the inputs, you are also able to play this way. The downside is, unless you like French kissing TVs, you're not gonna wanna be up close and personal. The cable that's provided is extremely short, and unless you have an extender, it's highly unlikely you're going to use this added cable they give you. The other downside to the BitBoy is the fact that you can't actually plug in headphones if you wanted to play privately and not have people around you hear what you're hearing. There is a really nice control wheel that controls the volume, and the external speaker isn't too bad. From time to time, you'll hear popping and crackling like when you're in the pre-game right before you load up any of the 129 games, but beyond all that, it's actually not too bad. Control-wise, I was pleasantly surprised. The buttons are springy and bounce back pretty quickly. There's really no input lag, only specific ROMs suffered this. And speaking more about the ROMs, I mean, there are some pretty big ticket names in the games list here. Entirely intact, by the way. So we have like Super Mario Brothers, Super Mario Brothers 3, Contra, Mortal Kombat. We have Ninja Gaiden 1 through 3, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Darkwing Duck, Batman, Spider-Man, Wolverine, even Mega Man is in here, but it has the name of the Japanese counterpart, which is Rockman. There are even some ROMs in here that really make me question why they're on here. For example, one of the biggest ones that pops out to me is something called Harry's Legend. Now, this is actually a pretty infamous game because it's based off of another infamous game called Titanic, which was supposed to be a Titanic game in which you fight on the boat, and well, now they've just replaced all the sprites with Harry Potter, so that's what you get. And there are many more games that do this. The other thing is too, in the instruction manual, even on the website, it says that all of the games are in English, and that's just not true. One example that jumps to my mind, if you try playing Power Rangers 2, it's completely in Japanese. Sure, you're still gonna have a lot of fun playing it, but unless you know how to read Japanese, you're really not gonna know what's going on in the game. and I don't think it really matters at this point. The BitBoy itself is a pretty cool device. If you have extra time on your hands, or maybe you just want to slide a gaming console in your pocket, it's cool to hop into Mario and skip a couple of worlds and try to see how far you can get, or try to speedrun the first world in a 5-minute trip on a bus or something like that. But beyond all that, the BitBoy is for a specific type of person. If you think that you're interested in learning more about the BitBoy, I will have the website linked down below in the description. Once again, if you guys want to enter to win the BitBoy that I talked about at the beginning of this video, go ahead and leave a like on the video, follow me over on Twitter, and make sure to leave a comment about your favorite retro game. Anyway, guys, that is it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, click the like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And until tomorrow, my friends, I will see ya. Peace.